Saturday, 19th of June. Time now is 3 p.m. We just had this box brought in to us not an hour ago, and inside it is another bird. And this is what it is.
Tell me how you feel.
A baby jackdaw.
Tell me love is real.
But we've got to look after this baby jackdaw until such time as it's old enough to fend for itself. But having a look, this bird tells me a different story than other than being wild. For instance, if you look at the tail feathers, the end of the tail feathers are white and stuck together. This tells me that it's been inside a little cage for a while, and also the feathers are dull, very dull, and started to wave. Now this tells me that it has lack of UV light and kept in a dark place. The feathers are dried out. Another little clue is that the bird is absolutely very, very tame. It jumps on my hand, sits there quite happy, no problem whatsoever. No matter what type of baby bird you see or find, whether it's a jackdaw, crow, blackbird, no matter whether it's a thrush or a jay or a sparrow, if they are fully feathered, please leave them alone. These birds have to learn to fly, but if we keep picking them up, they become humanized. They don't know what they are. They don't know what species they are. This bird, if it was in someone's hands that doesn't know what they're doing, they will feed it and feed it and feed it and keep it very, very tame. The bird can talk and it will do tricks and it will do all sorts of things. That's not what we want. It's a wild bird and this jackdaw must stay wild. But where it is looking, it's already humanized and tame. Meanwhile, this little jackdaw, as you can see, is doing absolutely brilliant, aren't you? Surgical spirits, we found this little fella on the road, and as you can see, he's got maggots all over him, but we're going to clean them off, and we use surgical spirits on a cotton wool bud. This should instantly kill them. I'm about to show you how. This is the first procedure of taking away maggots that have infected a slight wound on any bird. Surgical spirits is actually killing them, as you can see, instantly. I'm giving them a little tiny piece of meat, which is cat meat. There must be thousands upon thousands of maggots in here. Side of his bill. In there, absolutely thousands. Once these have gone, I want to see whether there is any in his throat. That's the dangerous part. That's most of the maggots gone now. And what we're actually doing is now cleaning up the nostril part. As you can see, it's right down to the bone. That's the top mandible. As you can see, that's about 99% of these maggots that have now gone. It's stinging him a little bit, but he doesn't really mind. As you can see, they don't show pain whatsoever. So I know they do feel the pain, but they don't show it because they do not understand what it is. And that is why you see birds jumping around, flying with broken wings, broken legs. There you go. All done. My next procedure is to have a look down his mouth and see if he's got any maggots down there. And if he has, we've got to start again. So this has taken us about an hour to get these off. Now we're going to have a look down his mouth. We're just having a look down his mouth now to see if there's any maggots in there. And as you can see, it's clean. No maggots, so it looks as if we've got them all before they actually went straight down his throat.